Hello guys, welcome back to this channel. So thank you for joining me today. Today I do have a prophetic word, and this word is a warning. I know a lot of people don't like warnings, but I have to, you know, bring out this warning because it was overdue. This warning was at the end of, you know, last month when the Holy Spirit was talking to me. Unfortunately, my family went through, you know, an attack. My grandma was in the hospital and a lot of things happened. So I was mostly basically distracted. The more I wanted to release a video, the more things came about. But, you know, I kept on asking the Holy Spirit that he needed to make room and bring peace around me so that way I can have the strength to be able to release this video. And today has been such a good day to release this video, and the good news is that my grandma is okay. You know, we did pray for her and we did seek the Lord because I didn't think it was time for her to go anywhere. So I pleaded with God and God heard our prayers, and she looks healthy and she is a blessing. We did seek God for a miracle and God answered, and the enemy tried to bring a scare twice, but you know, we kept on thanking God and worshiping him and understanding that we can depend on him and he's the healer, and that God loves us so much because we refused. I refused, and you know, I trusted God to, you know, keep my grandma healthy and safe because I didn't think, you know, it was her time. And this year has been a crazy year because I've lost my grandparents from my mom's side of family, and you know, and my granddaddy himself was a man who never, he knew about God, but he never had a relationship with Jesus Christ. And on the day that he was dying, like a few days before he died, I remember my mom telling me to call him, but I never had a good relationship with him. So my mom had to allow me to, you know, talk to me. She pushed me to talk to him, and she was like, you need to talk to him. And you know, when I was talking to him on the phone, it was one of those God-given moments where God allowed me to release exactly what I was feeling in my heart and just to have that conversation. And I remember talking to him, and he basically told me like he didn't want, like, you know, to talk to me in a sense. And then I asked him if we can pray. Like, I ignored everything and I asked him if we can pray, and you know, he was just like, no, can you just pray for me, you know, when you get off the phone? And I was like, no, granddaddy, I want to pray with you. And I prayed with him, and that was the last time that I had a conversation, and I told him that I loved him, and that was the end. You know, after that, a few days later, he died. And I'm so glad that I was able to talk to him. Actually, I do believe that God did that to break off everything that I, you know, held on to, even though, you know, it was something that I felt like it was very generational in a sense. And I kept on praying for you know, I kept on praying for restoration, but that's how God did it. God allowed me to say goodbye in a nice way, and God allowed me to tell him that I loved him before he died, and I'm grateful for that. So this year has been a year of attacks, and I'm so sorry guys, this year has been a year of attacks. But one of my biggest cry is that, you know, a lot of people may die without having a relationship with Christ. sorry guys. So as you guys can know, that a lot of people can die without having a relationship with Christ, and it is very important to have that relationship with Christ, because if you are not ready, you are definitely going to go to hell. As much as people want to ignore the facts, but hell and heaven are real, and the only way to Jesus Christ is acknowledging, you know, the only way to heaven is acknowledging that Jesus Christ is alive, guys. But all I know that he was a man who did not acknowledge Jesus, you know, and it is very sad. But I'm so grateful that I was able to pray with him on the phone and tell him that I loved him. And that was the beauty of everything. So, and you know, who are we to, you know, God is the one who orders our steps, and God is the one who numbers, you know, our days, you know. And I pray that, you know, a lot of people are ready to receive God, because you never know what happens in life. Life happens by surprise. Even God tells us all the time that, you know, man can plan his ways, but God orders their steps. And the Bible also tells us all the time to remind us that, you know, God is the one who knows the day that we're gonna go, okay? So don't live your life thinking that, you know, today or tomorrow you own the day. No, you don't. You don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow, and that's just the way it is. Things happen so suddenly and they happen so surprisingly. But the coolest thing about this whole relationship and love of God is that we can trust God with our lives, even though in the unknown. We can trust him to know that, you know, he's ordering our lives and he's protecting us. We can trust him for that. So I just wanted to share this with you guys, that, you know, the enemy is on the rampant and life is very surprising. You never know what happens in life, but are you ready? Are you the bride of Christ? You know, and that's the thing that, you know, those are the prophetic warnings that God, you know, was giving me. Like, you know, the prophetic warning that he was giving me is guard your oil, you know. And October month was full of confusion, and we understand that October is a month of witchcraft and all that stuff, because it's a month where the enemy celebrates and those who are with him are celebrating unbeknownst, because they think it's so cute and so, you know, innocent. But it's the lie of the enemy and it's the hidden agenda of the enemy, and those who are asleep will not see the truth or the light of Christ, because, you know, they think it's normal, and the enemy has normalized everything to the point where, you know, people don't even know what is the devil and what is God, because they think that everything's the same as long as it pleases their flesh. And that's basically what's going on. So guys, I'm so sorry about the lighting, because I have, you know, I'm using natural light to record this video. 9/17/2020, when I was in the hospital with my grandma, I took a nap, I went to sleep, and while I was sleeping, I had a vivid dream. I was driving and then I almost got in an accident. And during that accident, I found myself, you know, trying to stop. But, you know, as I was trying to stop, I tried to stop, but I had to stop in front of the Target, my favorite store. So, you know, sometimes God uses symbols to show me the things I love. I love Target. So I was in front of the Target store. And then in the Target store, So I stopped in front of Target, like literally in front of the store, not in the parking lot, but in front of the store. And in the front of the store, I remember in the dream, I was telling myself to press caution. Caution. That's what I kept on saying. Caution, caution, caution. So, and I pressed the caution, but I remember that in both sides, I had, you know, cars were going to come and hit me. That's what I remembered. I was like, somebody's going to hit me in the front and somebody can hit me in the back. So, you know, and then God, you know, after a few days, and I was asking God, like, what in the world? Why would you give me such a dream, you know? And then the Holy Spirit explained to me, and he was like, you need to be on guard. And he was like, guard your oil. And I was like, guard my oil. So I spent some time, you know, asking the Holy Spirit for this prophetic revelation. And this is, are you ready, bride of Christ? You know, are you ready? Are you a bride of Christ? And are you guarding your oil? Is that what God is trying to tell us in this moment? So before we get started, guys, and I am so sorry that I took longer, but before we get started, we are going to pray and ask the Holy Spirit to be in this conversation, so that way I can release this word and allow the Holy Spirit to just move and use my mouth as I share whatever it is, and as I share God's heart with everyone. So let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we just worship you. We just give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor and adoration. For you are worthy, and that you are mighty. For you are everlasting, oh God. Father God, there is none like you on this earth, oh God. Even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, oh my Father God, we will fear no evil, because you're always with us, oh God. You're always protecting us, and you're always covering us, oh God. Father God, we just pray, Lord God, that you may just prepare us, oh God, in a way that we are ready to receive exactly that you have for us, oh God. Prepare us, oh God, so we can be the a bride that is pure and blameless in your sight, oh my Father God. We just ask you, Lord God, that you may just help our hearts, oh God, to yield to your purpose, to your plans, and to always be ready for you, oh God. Father God, we come against the plans of the enemy. We come against the schemes of the enemy, oh God. We come against every witch, every warlock, every anything, oh God, that does not bring you glory, my Father God. Holy Spirit, I just invite you in this conversation. I just pray, Lord God, even as I release this warning, oh God, Father God, I pray, Lord God, that you may just fill this video with your glory, with your anointing, oh my Father God. I just come against every stronghold. I come against every power and ruler and authority, oh God. Father God, may you arise and all our enemies be scattered in Jesus' name. Father God, we just thank you, Lord God, for the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for your mercy and grace, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you love us so much, enough to give us a warning, enough to bring us to where you want us, oh God. Father God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, that you're always with us and that you will never forsake us and leave us, oh God. Thank you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. So today's word is basically, are you a bride of Christ? You know, are you ready? Is your oil ready? You know, so when the Holy Spirit told me, 2 weeks ago, he told me, guard your oil. And I was like, guard my oil? You know, I didn't understand. So he gave me the first dream about, you know, being careful who I am around, because a lot of people are not with you, even though they smile and they look so happy, especially when God has promised you a lot of things. There's a lot of threats in the, you know, the spiritual realm too, because I've been having dreams that are very interesting. Like, let me just say this. One of the dreams that I had was somebody was trying to marry me off in the dream, and I found it so awkward because they asked me where I wanted to get married. So I told them the details where I wanted to get married, but for some reason they took me somewhere else. So I told them, I was like, first of all, my family is not here, and second of all, how am I gonna get married when the person that I'm, you know, waiting for is not even here? And I wanted somebody in my life, somebody that means a lot in my life, to be there, and they were not there. So I was like, I'm not getting married because the person that, you know, supposed to be here is not here, you know. I believe that these kingdom marriages are, they have so much anointing, and that the enemy is so afraid for this to happen. But be still and know that God is God, and that he's not limited. What he has spoken is going to happen, no matter what the enemy is trying to devise against. That's one thing that I would not, like, you have to push past everything that's going on, past whatever you're seeing, especially also with everything that's going on. Like, our eyes are too small for God, you know, they're too small for God. We don't see the way God sees. And if God has spoken, I think we should continue being faithful and continue praising him and continue to allow him to, you know, work in us and continue to do whatever he has planned for our lives. Just have faith and hold on, because the enemy is rolling. Like, I have never seen so many attacks, and I'm just like, okay, you know, just continue praying, continue studying the word of God, because prayer is a weapon. Like, it doesn't matter, like, prayer is the greatest weapon. The word of God is going to build up your faith. So trust God. And yes, this walk is not easy, and the pressure keeps on increasing and increasing, but something has to be pressurized before it gets beautiful. And when God's timing happens, which is going to happen, because we see that, you know, a lot of things are happening, you know, to attack, you know, this is what I always discern. If the enemy is attacking the same thing that God is supposed to give you, just know that you already got it. You're already victorious. But the enemy is trying to threaten you, so that way you can be so fearful and lose your faith. And when you lose your faith, that causes delay. It doesn't mean that God won't give it to you, but it just causes delay. But I want to encourage everyone who's waiting on something, that be prepared. Be the bride of Christ. You know, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should change his mind. It is going to happen. It is going to happen, and I know that. I can feel it in the spirit, and I can feel it, and I'm holding on to the word of God that he will bring it to pass. But today's prophetic word is a prophetic warning, and I'm so sorry for rambling on. I hope this video does not take long. So the prophetic warning is guarding your oil. And basically, when I thought about guarding the oil, it was basically the 10 version, you know, the parable of the 10 virgins, which is Matthew chapter 25, verse 1 through 13. And we are going to read that. And it says, At the time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. Five of them were foolish and five were wise. The foolish ones took their lamps, but did not take any oil with them. The wise ones, however, took oil in their jars along with their lamps. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and sleepy. At midnight, the cry rang out, "Here's the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all the virgins woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil. Our lamps are going out." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both of us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the others also came. "Lord, Lord," they said, "open the doors for us." But they replied, "Truly, I tell you, I don't know you. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know the day or the hour." So one of the biggest things that, you know, that happened is like, you know, God was telling me that salvation can't be shared, but Jesus Christ is the one who came in this world to give salvation to everyone, to those who acknowledge and accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. They have salvation. So the other thing is that, you know, God was teaching me to share this sermon and say, are we prepared? Are we a prepared bride? You know, are we seeking the kingdom of God? You know, do we know what is required in this preparation? Are you a prepared bride? Because the bridegroom knows and receives those who are like him, okay? God knows who are for him. And are you for God, or are you for, you know, are you lukewarm and living the life thinking that, you know, you are a prepared bride? Like, if you have your own measurement and the requirements, if you are not reading the word of God as, you know, a tool to prepare you to be a bride of Christ, then you are not, you know, living your life as God requires you through his word. Those who are prepared in Christ are very attentive, you know, to the times they're living in. They're very attentive, and you know, they are very attentive and they're very prepared, you know, because we know that God is going to show up on time in our lives. God, you know, he's a God of time. We may not understand his timing, but his timing is always, you know, perfect. And we also know that God has a set time when he's going to show up. So all of us have to, you know, be the brides, you know, the first brides that were prepared and that were wise. And we have to model Christ's characteristics, you know, if we want to be, you know, the bride of Christ. Because we don't want to be like the lazy brides who were unprepared and they were not attentive to what God is doing in the earth. We need to be attentive and prepared to share the gospel and understand that Jesus Christ is the only way, you know, and he's the only savior that can save our lives into having, you know, the afterlife that people talk about, you know, because there's only two things that can happen. You can either go to heaven or you can go to hell. A lot of people think that there's another way. No, Jesus Christ is the only way to, you know, to heaven. And we see that the other five brides that were lazy, you know, they were told to go back and get their own oil. So we need to have our own oil ready. Is your oil ready? You know, if something happens suddenly, you know, and I've seen that in this year, things have happened suddenly. I've lost two of my friends, you know, out of sudden leaves, and it's so surprising. You can look at somebody looking healthy and then suddenly something happens, you know, and you wish that that person, you know, was in Christ. And most of the people that have seen gone, my question was, did they even have a relationship with Christ? And those are the questions that I had. And it was so sad and heartbreaking to know that I'm not sure. When you see somebody who loves Jesus Christ, and when you know, there's so much joy that you take in. Like an example is Ravi Zachariah. you see that Ravi Zachariah, when he died, everybody knew. You just had that confidence that he went to heaven with the Lord Jesus Christ. You just knew that. That's the kind of life you want to live. You know, the Bible says, let your light shall shine before men so they can see the glory that is in you, right? That God has put in you. They can know who your life testifies for. And if your life testifies for Christ, everything is going to reflect Christ. Your fruits or the spirits are going to reflect, you know, Jesus Christ. And that's the kind of life that you want to lead. So whenever you die, people have the confidence that you actually went to Jesus Christ. Okay. And that's the kind of life that you want to live on this earth. That's the kind of legacy you want to live on this earth. Not the legacy where you question everything. Like, you know, was this bride prepared? You know, that's a question that I had for my granddaddy. That's a question that I had for my friends, because I wasn't sure what kind of life they were living. You know, and you don't want to have a questionable life, but you want to have a life that knows that you were ready, you had your oil ready. And when the bridegroom, you know, gets announced, you are ready to show up with everything, right? We know that the oil in this, we know that the oil in this chapter of Matthew chapter 25, the story of the virgins, is that the oil is the Holy Spirit. You know, do you have the Holy Spirit leading your life? Do you listen to the Holy Spirit? Do you acknowledge Jesus? Can the Holy Spirit testify with your spirit that your spirit is hidden in Christ Jesus? Those are the things that we have to understand. So, and that's the thing that the Holy Spirit was, you know, telling me, guard your oil. Like, don't be like the foolish, don't be like the foolish virgins who were not prepared and the oil was not ready, and they decided to just, you know, keep on going and walking around. They decided to just, you know, turn around and thinking that they had time to go back and get the oil. You don't got time to go get back the oil. You need to live a life that is prepared. You need to live a life that is surrendered. You need to live a life that is sanctified, and understanding that, you know, if you were to die today, that Jesus will receive you, you know, and he will not shut the door on you like the way he did for the, you know, the other foolish virgins. You don't want him to, you know, question you like the last part. What does it say? It says, later the others, verse 11 all the way to 13, says, later the others came, Lord, Lord, they said, open the door for us. But he replied, truly, I tell you, I don't know you. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know the hour, you know. And this is not to scare anybody, but I want to encourage you guys to understand that, you know, Jesus can come soon. And, you know, your exit may not just be, you know, just your exit may not just be this one time where, you know, when God comes to get his bride. No, your exit might be just death. And I've seen that this year. And it has been a year of shaking, awakening, and understanding that you need Jesus, okay? We need Jesus during this time. And, you know, Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the light. And I pray that the bride is ready. And I pray that this message has touched your heart. And understand that God is doing a new thing in all of us, and that he's working out everything on our behalf. Just wait for him. The enemy is roaring. Continue praying and continue trusting in the Lord with everything. And I just wanted to share, you know, this prophetic word. You know, guard your oil, be ready, be the bride of Christ, and be what God wants you to be, and allow him to continue being the director of your life. So for those who are new, I just want to say thank you for subscribing to this channel and for sharing, and understand that, you know, God is working in all of us. It is, this year is a wonderful year, but at the same time, it is something new. And understand that, yes, the intensity of persecution is going to increase. It's just based on the, you know, the things that God has been sharing with me. And, you know, God is doing a new thing in the earth. And I do believe that persecution is going to increase, you know, because when the enemy, when the enemy doesn't get what he wants, he's going to hump up. But we know that, you know, that everything is under subject of Jesus Christ. So therefore, we have the authority because the same power that raised Jesus from the dead lives in us. So we're more than conquerors, and we're not defeated, but we're victorious through Jesus Christ. So we are going to pray, and I hope you guys can share this video, subscribe and share comments, and and I pray that God continues moving in your life and continues directing us. And we're just going to pray and close out this message. Jesus, we just thank you that you are worthy and that you are mighty. We thank you, Lord God, that you hear us and that you protect us, oh God. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, that we're victorious in your name. And Father God, we thank you, Lord God, that we are alive right now for a time as this because you have a purpose in us, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that we are hidden in you, oh God. We thank you, Lord God. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for each and every person that's going to be watching this video. I pray, Lord God, that you may just bring encouragement. I pray that you may just bring peace in their life, oh God, to understand that you love them and you have a purpose for them. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. So guys, I will see you next time and be blessed because God is doing a new thing in the earth, and trust him. Do not perceive everything with your emotions or your eyes, but ask the Holy Spirit to open up your eyes to see what is in his heart. And how we know that is when we dive into the Word of God, because when we align ourselves with the Word of God and we continue reading the Word of God, there's something that happens in the Spirit. It's like your heart can actually discern what is in God's heart because he gives you a new heart, okay? And that's what I love about Jesus Christ. That's why I say it's a personal relationship, because people might think that you're crazy. But that relationship is like a marriage, guys. It's only intimate, and it only gets better and better, according to how you want to build your marriage. So if you want your marriage to grow with Christ, you need to keep on seeking him first, and you water your marriage and make it better by understanding what your groom wants, which is Jesus, your husband wants, understanding what he wants from you, and caring and intimately falling in love with him, and growing that relationship. So, and that's it. I will see you guys next time, and be blessed, and share. Bye.